"What is it you say?" inquired the judge. Every eye was fixed on the witness.
"Repeat what you said, Teruggi," commanded Sir Joseph Molloy in a stern voice. But the Italian remained silent. Then he saw that the judge was looking at him with what appeared to his excited mind a terrible and threatening expression. So, reluctantly, came his answer.
"I only remark in my own language that it is folly to try and make an elephant out of a fly, Your Eminence."
Everyone present felt that the Italian had scored. The rest of the evidence for the prosecution, though it took up many hours, was comparatively unimportant. Dr. Grant, the elderly physician who had come to the house in response to Mrs. Dowstone's telephone call, cut a poor figure in the witness box, for he had to admit that, though he had at once thought Dowstone's death presented suspicious features, he had signed a certificate stating the cause to be heart disease. Again, he had waited 3 weeks before he had communicated his suspicions to the coroner, and he had only done so because that gentleman happened to be a friend of his. This was the only remaining witness for the Crown over whom Sir Joseph Molloy took any real trouble. By a series of apparently innocent and simple questions, he made it quite clear to the judge, and he hoped equally clear to the jury, that Dr. Grant was violently prejudiced against the prisoner. Now, such prejudice in a British court of law always acts, illogical though it may appear, in favour of a man or woman on trial for his or her life. The opening speech for the defence was short and took the form of a submission on Sir Joseph Molloy's part that there was not and never had been sufficient evidence against Laura Dowstone to make it right or reasonable that she should have been arrested on a charge of murder. Instead of attacking the evidence for the prosecution, her advocate put the whole of his powerful intellect to proving that what evidence there was told equally against Angelo Teruggi. This man, he asserted truly, was obviously innocent. His master, though mean and penurious by nature, had yet raised his wages twice and had promised to pay, should he stay a whole year in his service, half Teruggi's holiday return ticket to Italy.